第25队表演的题目是 The New Southbound Policy. Let's power up, Myanmar. 计时开始。
Myanmar has been all over the news. Myanmar's electricity supply is a lot more stable now thanks to Taiwan's migratory system. Not to mention its tremendous help to the economy grow. You guys have made power available to more people than ever before. Had it not been for the new southbound policy, which encourages our collaboration, I could have never thought I could have a chance to meet Giselle
Thomas
and have a place in Southeast Asian markets.
Hey, I have a good idea. How about we all take a celebratory retreat to Taiwan? I have heard a lot about Taiwan's delicious food, beautiful landscape, and friendly people.
Yeah!
Let's set the date to start packing.
Let's do it!
Bell.
Thank you.
The 26队表演的题目是 Friendly Environment for Muslim Tourists. 计时开始。
Hey everybody, come here! Welcome to Fairy Hotel! We will stay here tonight, and the filming will take your luggage to your room. Moreover, this hotel also provides a buffet with halal certification. And today's special is assorted sashimi. Please enjoy your dinner.And have a nice evening. And I will ask the chef to explain the menu with you.
Good evening, man. I'm the chef of this hotel. Our dinner buffet also provides meals with halal certification, like pan-fried abalone, cream gratin in French style, deep-fried squash and squibble, etc.All of those dishes are made by local Taiwanese ingredients. Hope you enjoy.
Welcome, ma'am. Please follow me and let me take you to your seat. This area are for Muslims, and this is our original dish, stone grilled meat.
Why is that? Is that pork?
Yes, it is.
Oh, I thought all the dishes in this area are for Muslims.Pork is forbidden for Muslims.
Oh, I'm really sorry. Must be something wrong. Let me confirm this with chef. Please wait a moment.
Sorry, ma'am. This dish should not be here. We are really sorry. We apologize for making you uncomfortable.
That's okay. It happens sometimes. Not everyone totally understands the Muslim cultures and taboos.Pork is forbidden for Muslims containing pork products. For example, marshmallow, black rice pudding, and meatballs.
We didn't use those kind of ingredients. Don't worry, please enjoy your meal.
Thank you for doing this. Please follow me and let me take you to your seat.
Taiwan is a beautiful island, isn't it?
Yes, Taiwan is very beautiful, and people are friendly too.
But when did you come to Taiwan?
I came to Taiwan to observe Taiwan's medical system, because Taiwanese government has a visa-free policy for our country. So, I have an opportunity to come here. So, how about you? Why did you come to Taiwan?
I come here just because Taiwan has released a tourist visa for Asians, as well as diversified poverty and sightseeing, improving the quality of tour guides and establishing a friendly environment for Muslim tourism.
Yes, I also heard that the new southbound policy on youth is divided mainly into two parts,
talent exchange and resource sharing.
In terms of talent exchange,the deepened cultivation of bilateral young scholars, students, and industrial manpower, and also complementarity to sharing our resources with partner countries.
Yes, at present, Taiwanese government also promotes the new southbound policy and cooperation between
Taiwan, South Asia, New Zealand, Australia,
and other countries.
Hey, don't forget. The most important things about resource sharing is to use soft powers, such as culture, tourism, medical care, technology agriculture, and small and medium enterprises.
Welcome to Taiwan and hope you have a nice journey. Thank you for your watching.
第27队表演的题目是 New Southbound Policy, A New Path for Youth. 计时开始。
Hey guys, come here. I'm looking at a wanted ad that is recruiting international volunteers. We've been eager to be volunteers, haven't we?
Exactly, and then?
I'm serving a website about you, the Europe's working team.
What's that about?
It's an international organization. You would like to teach children in Apple English, right? Maybe we can try that.
That seems to be a good idea.
Me too. I've been longing to teach the local in Indonesia's hygienic knowledge.
We too also want to join you.
Well, we prefer to do cultural interaction in Thailand.
Sounds great. Actions speak louder than
words. Let's do it.
Meet foreign visitors asking for directions. All of you can help them correctly and clearly.
Miss, how do you do today?
You all did a great job today. I find that you're more confident than you used to be. English isn't difficult at all as long as you dare to speak out loud, is it?
I agree, and I enjoy practicing English with everybody.
Me too. I'm pleased to see your gradual progress, which makes me feel a sense of achievement. I also learn and grow a lot by teaching you guys, and I can speak English more fluently than ever. Just keep practicing. I believe that all of you will own excellent English ability in the future. Okay, it's time for outdoor activities.
Yeah, hurry up!
Hello everyone, I'm your big brother from Taiwan. Today, we are going to learn how to prevent dengue fever. Does anyone know what dengue fever is?
I know. When someone is bitten by specific mosquitoes, he or she may have a high fever or even death. It's usually occurs in summer.
Good answer. Dengue fever is actually a mosquito-borne disease. Anyone who contracts the disease may have sudden high fever, severe headache, joint and muscle pain, vomiting as well as skin rash, etc.
Dengue fever is horrible, and then how can we protect ourselves from infection?
There is no vaccine to prevent dengue fever. The best way to prevent the disease is to prevent by infecting mosquitoes and to keep the environment really clean to decrease the mosquito populations. We can get rid of the places where mosquitoes can breed. This includes old tires, cans, or flower pots that collect rain. Is that clear to everyone?
Yes, we have learned a lot about dengue fever. Thanks, teacher.
Country, and not only local culture, but many different foreign cultures can be found in Taiwan. Today, I'm going to introduce some of the exotic cultures to you guys.
Like what?
For example, we have Songkran Festival originated from Thailand, Vietnamese restaurant, and Indian cuisine everywhere in Taiwan.
Are those countries rather target nations of Taiwan's New Southbound Policy?
Exactly. New Southbound Policy stands for economic cooperation and resources sharing among Taiwan and least Southeast Asian countries, which is beneficial to all and can make a win-win situation. What's more, if you'd like to go to Taiwan for further study, our government can provide you with scholarships.
Awesome.
Sounds great, right?
Awesome. I'd like to learn more about Taiwan after listening to your introductions. I think I'll visit Taiwan someday.
Me too.
That's great. And don't forget to mention that anyone participating in the project can apply for an allowance from the government. I believe that this can encourage more people to Dunedin themselves to overseas volunteer work and to interact with foreigners, which can also promote the image of Taiwan around the world.
That's right. I can agree with you more.
That's why we need to promote this activity, making it a new national movement.
Thanks for watching.
第二十八队表演的题目是《An Adventure to Vietnam》，计时开始。
What should I do? I just got my diploma, but finding a job isn't so easy. Now my stepmother and stepsisters are making me do all the chores. What is that? A dragon fruit?And it's from Vietnam.
Finally, fresh air. I've been stuck in that little magic fruit for so many years. Oh,
excuse me.
Oh, my dear master, I am the Tinkerbell of the South, and I will grant you a wish. What is your name?
Really? I'm Cinderella. Please help me find a job.I'm dying to find one!
My master, you are lucky to be in Taiwan. Did you know that you can go south to another country to develop your bright and shiny future?
Wow, I never thought of that. I'm beginning to see some light at the end of the tunnel.
Great! Come with me. Let's head south together and I'll show you the way. Ah, I see where we can land. Vietnam!
Wow, this place is beautiful. Wait, who's over there? Hello, ma'am. Do you work here?
Oh, Xin Zhao. My name is Snow. I farm this land, and I plant delicious fruits.
I see. But are you doing this all alone? Don't you have any helpers?
Well, I wish my husband...and seven children have time to help me. But they're busy from working and studying. I toil day and night to secure a better tomorrow.
But why do you plant your fruit out in the open field? Don't you worry about heavy rain ruining your crops?
This is how we do it here. Our fruits are often ruined by bad weather, pests, and diseases.
Ma'am, don't worry.My master is from Taiwan, where they develop technology to improve agriculture. Maybe she can help you.
You are from Taiwan? Cinderella, please teach me your way.
I may know how to do it, but... Oh, my fairy godmother. She's an expert in this field. Tinkerbell.
Not a problem. Let's bring her here.
What?What is this place? I was doing experiments, and then all of a sudden, I'm here? My dear fairy godmother, it's me, Cinderella. We're now in Vietnam. Meet my new friends.
I see. But what brings me here?
Snow is a farmer here suffering from horrible weather that affects her crops. We are trying to find a solution for her.
And that is why I brought you here.
Oh, Mrs. Godmother, please help me.I have seven children to raise.
Then, no worries. You've asked the right person. I have been investigating in greenhouse agriculture technology in Taiwan for quite some time.
Greenhouse? Agriculture? Technology? What is that?
Let's see. Bibbidi bobbidi boo! Look back there. That is a greenhouse.
Wow! The walls and the roofare used to protect the fruits from bad weather and diseases, right?
Bingo! That is exactly the purpose of a greenhouse. So when you plant your fruit in a greenhouse,
they won't be affected by the bad weather.
Yes, insects and diseases are not likely to destroy your crops.
Oh, greenhouse technology seems to be a perfect solution for me. But how exactly is Taiwan gonna introduce this to Vietnam?
Good question. A part of the new southbound policy includes cooperation in agriculture and talent exchanges between Taiwan and other countries.
And as a collaboration between two countries, greenhouse technology will be able to help improve the conditions of your dragon fruit.
Wow, I can already see my juicy dragon fruit and my seven children growing up happily. Thank you, Cinderella.
I never know that as a younger generation of Taiwan, we can achieve great goals of cooperation by assisting other countries. I've already found home and direction for my future.
Oh, Cinderella, I'm so proud of you.
I'll make sure I refer to researchers in Taiwan and make use of them in my future.
And you can develop your new career in Vietnam.
Oh, I can't wait to get started to build my own greenhouse.
No matter what problems we encounter, if we cooperate with one another, we'll make the world even better.
Thank you.
The 29队表演的题目是 Incredible India. 计时开始。
Wait, Stacy!
If you have any doubts, we can head home now.
But I want to go to India to work and travel around for 1 year.
Stacy, I've heard that India is dirty, messy, not to mention innumerable cases of rape and robbery.
It's 2012 now, and I'm brave and will be careful.
Whatever.
Is that okay? Since I didn't see him up this morning.
He has been terribly worried recently. Here's the money Dad wants me to give you.
No, I'm already 22. I can support myself.
Bring it in case of emergency. By the way, it's your dad that pays for your flight to India. It is the only way Dad shows his love and tenderness.
Really? But I'm a bad daughter.
Passengers for CI1A1. To New Delhi, please go to gate 20.
Time to fly, my sweet.
Mom, please say thank you, Dad. He's the world's number one dad, always. What a lousy day again! I've been working in this travel agency for 3 months. Six days a week, now's a day, but I only get $9,000 a month. It actually is just my internship subsidy. I nearly have no money left to support my life and my dreams to travel around India. What's this? A job opening for someone who can speak Chinese and English in front of a camera? All you need is a resume! Simple as that! Time for lunch!
Cheap, cheap, cheap! My friend, Japan, Korea, China, which country?
Taiwan!
Yeah, Taiwan. The world supplier of microchips and HTC.
Wow, you know Taiwan?
We also call Taiwan papaya country because of its booming agriculture. Wanna buy this of Vendo mangoes for 100 rupees?
No, too expensive.
90, 80. My friend, for how much will you buy? 70 rupees. It's the final price.
50 rupees. Make a friend, come on. 50 rupees or I'll go home.
Deal.
I got it! A screening job interview as a TV reporter!
Congratulations, my dearest friend!
Phoenix TV correspondent Stacy Yeo is in New Delhi. The people striding behind me are the demonstrators for the bus scarab case. They are shouting, "Hand the criminal and we demand justice." Sir, what's your opinion on the demonstration?
situation.
The Gangri case is terrible.
You don't look like an Indian, do you?
I am from Taiwan. Are you Taiwanese too?
Yeah, I'm from Taiwan too. Why did you leave Taiwan for India?
I was once an exchange student in Jawaharlal Nehru University thanks to New Southbound Policy.
What's that?
New Southbound Policy helps to boost Taiwan's advantaged industry such as solar power, electric vehicles, LED, smart cities technology, as well as teaching Chinese as a second language here in India.
You really know a lot!
Actually, I prefer to know you more. It's almost time for work. Give me your line ID so that we can talk more about this issue later.
Sounds great!
Thank you.
The 30-day 表演的题目是 Taiwan, a frontier of educational enlightenment. 计时开始。
Architecture really take us back into a different time in history. Jasmine, did you say that you're going to study in England after graduation?
Yes, I think England is a great choice for studying abroad.
Wait, have you ever thought about studying here, in Taiwan? You don't need to go that far to attend a world-class university.
With our success in various fields, Taiwan has a quality education that will prepare you for success.
Well, yeah, I suppose it's also good that Taiwan is closer to home and it offers a safe and friendly environment, like Korean rooms or halal restaurants for Muslims like us.
You might be right, but I'm not so sure, since our Western universities have a strong reputation and global community.
Going to those countries may lead to a great future,
yeah.
And everyone seems to think that they're the best choices.
That's true.
Hold on, hold on. Let me show you what Taiwan universities have to offer and explain something extraordinary about the policy nowadays that connects us.
National Zhongshan University.
Hey! There's a festival going on! It's the International Cultural Festival!
And some of them are wearing our traditional clothing.
These Taiwanese universities host such events to express their passion for international cultures.
I can't believe this. This is amazing.
This university must be a very friendly place for international students to study.
Yep, and this is one of the universities in Taiwan which offers scholarships for international students. Congratulations!
What a about other universities in Taiwan?
Actually, all of the universities in Taiwan has offered scholarships for international students.
Really? It sounds like Taiwan is really committed to attracting foreign talents.
Indeed, the Taiwanese government has been promoting the new Southbound policy.
What's it about then?
The policy promotes cooperation with the ASEAN, the South Asian countries, Australia, and New Zealand.
Including Indonesia!
That is right.
One of the crucial components of this policy is called a New Southbound Talent Development Program, which aims to further expand and deepen a partnership.
Eric, our President Joko Widodo once mentioned that Taiwan and Indonesia economies complement each other perfectly.
Ah, so our country provides resources and markets. Taiwan then provides technology and techniques.
Quite, but knowledge is not the only thing. When it comes to applying for a job, experiences may be vitally important. Universities in Taiwan provide internship opportunities among a vast selection of companies.
These experiences of great value can be a huge boost when you return to your home country.
That's why my Indonesian friend who returned to Jakarta after pursuing studies in Taiwan turned out to be very competitive.
Really? I didn't expect that Taiwan has so much potential.
Yes, now I know that Taiwan offers many friendly and attractive educational environments for us. When it's my turn, wouldn't I love to explore the world outside? My future path is going to be studying Taiwan. Thank you, Max and Vivi, for informing us about this policy.
Yeah, thanks a lot. Jasmine, Taiwan's going to be on road to success.
Yes, I can't wait to get started.
With the new Southbound policy, our path to success awaits.
第三十一队表演的题目是 Keeping Our Options Open， 计时开始。
Welcome to ABSG News. I'm Amber Wong, and I'm Iris Chen coming to you live from Taiwan, where a national crisis is taking place.
That's right, Iris. With the birth rate continuing to fall across the country.We're now witnessing unprecedented numbers of school closures in all major cities.
As an increasing number of women are choosing careers over families, we see no solution in sight.
Hey Grace, how's the job hunt going?
Horrible!
This is an exercise in futility.I swear we'd have a better chance of finding a palm tree in the Arctic. I'm worried, Grace. Maybe teaching was the wrong career choice. Oh, I should have listened to our parents and went to med school.
Yeah, right. Your math sucks. Hey, no offense. Mine does too. Well, maybe Albie has some good news. At least she got an interview.
Here she is now.
So what happened?
5 years experience.
They want at least 5 years experience.
I'm telling you, there are no jobs for new graduates.
We're doomed, I tell ya, doomed.
Calm down. It's not the end of the world. Come on, Albie. You're a smart one. What's plan B?
Well, I did come across something at the job center, but it's, kind of big.
Big?
Extreme?
We move.
What? To the mountains? Oh, you know, I get
altitude sickness. No. Singapore.
Singapore?
Check this out.
You're serious, aren't you?
Just hear me out. They need teachers. The pay is awesome. And it's close, so we can fly home for the holidays.
Oh, I don't know.
Look, we can try it out for a year, and if we don't like it, we come back.What do you say?
All right.
Sharon?
What's a reliant?
Come on, let's get going.
Woman?
Welcome. Please take a seat.
Here are your contracts and some information about position available.
Make yourselves comfortable, and I'll be back shortly to answer any questions you may have.
Well, she seems nice.
I think so.
Here we are at last. I know everything's gonna work out just fine.
Oh yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Let's double what I'd be making in Taipei.
Oh, I hope they have beef noodles. I need my beef noodles. If they don't have beef noodles, I'm going back to Taiwan tonight.
Good afternoon, ladies. I'm Bonnie, the school's principal. You guys are sisters? So, Sharon, I'm told you can play and instruct the Kou Huang team.
Yes, for 13 years now.
Wonderful. You'll be a valuable addition to our music department.
Thank you.
And Grace, you teach traditional Chinese?
Yes, it's what we use in Taiwan. It's easy to read simplified after studying traditional, but the opposite cannot be said.
I see. Well, Chinese is becoming an increasingly important language in the world. And you teach English, Albi?
That's correct. I did my undergrad at NYU.
Well, as English is one of our official languages, as well as Chinese, you'll fit right in here.
Thanks.
All right then, are there any questions?
We should talk about this. Can we just have a minute or two to discuss a few things?
Sure. I'll just be in the next room. Give me a shower when you're ready.
We all do.
So, what do you think?
I don't know. I didn't see one beef noodle shop on the way here.
Well, I'm in.
But I don't know.
And so is she.
Okay.
We're gonna have a great time, you'll see. Now raise your right hand and repeat after me. I promise to work really hard and do my best.
I promise to work really hard and do my best.
And have an awesome time.
And have an awesome time. Yes.
Money, money, money.
All right.
Miss Bonnie.
So, we're in.
Great.
Just sign at the bottom and I'll take you to your residence.
What's he like?
Nice. He has a garden and a pool.
I'm not going anywhere near water. I've seen what those merlions look like.
Thank you. 第32队表演的题目是 Unlimited Exchanging Southbound Wonderland， 计时开始。
Bond policy makes my dream come true. Become an exchange student.
Hey, who are you? And what are these? Are you from India?
Hi, my name is Carrie, and I'm from New Delhi, India. Could you tell me where I am?
You are in Keeling High School in Ho Chi Minh City. My name is Anne, and this is Kevin.
Nice to meet you.
Oh, hey, Carrie. Are you an exchange student too?
Yeah, you're right. But I don't know where to go yet.
Have you guys heard about Taiwan? In my impression, Taiwan is high civilized and has many educational resources. The customs, religious, food, and weather are similar to ours. I really want to go there.
Are you insane? We have never left our own city. Not even to mention Vietnam. What if we can adapt to the Taiwanese life there? Or we can even make a single friend?
Hey, we're still very young and full of energy. We should try every opportunity. I agree to end. Let's go to Taiwan.
Let's go.
Wait, but what about the language? None of us here can speak Chinese.
Don't worry. We can communicate in English and learn Mandarin there. Let's go!
Come with us!
But what about my family? Yes, of course.
Hi, Tian.
Hi, Evan.
I heard you have started learning Chinese poems recently. Could you show us something interesting?
Nah, I haven't prepared enough yet. Besides, Kevin will make fun of me.
Don't forget about him. I'd like to hear it too.
Yes, please show us.
Okay, let me show you.
床前明月光，疑是地上霜。举头望明月，低头思故乡。
Hey, it's my eyes. Don't take it. Oh, hey, Jian. What's in your hand?
Oh, I've been working on latest application forms of new southbound policy. I'm considering going to India to learn more about computer engineering.
I have to say you make the right decision.
What's wrong, Diana? Is there anything I can help you?
Well, it seems that I need to spend a lot of money to study abroad.
No need to worry about the expense. You can apply for the full scholarship since you always get good grades. The new southbound policy covers quite a lot of the expenses.
Yes, and I suggest you go to Bangalore University.
Oh, Bangalore University.
Or other Institute of Science. I believe you can learn a lot of the latest high technology.
Besides, many Taiwanese industries want to invest in India.
Yeah, I know that. Like Foxconn.
Exactly. So that even if you graduated from the university in India, you won't have to worry about finding a job.
Okay. I'll fill out a form and send it out. After I go to India, you three must come to visit.
Of course.
Of course.
But before you go to India, I'm going to take you to taste the top 10 Taiwanese food so that you'll never forget Taiwan.
Hey, look at your belly. It's getting bigger. And don't forget, I am Taiwanese.
Okay, so the bill is on you.
Night market?
Why not?
Count me in.
Let's go!
Okay, first of all, I am very, very impressed by your English, by your performance, and I want to congratulate all of you. And now I'm going to criticize you, okay? But please, I'm not saying you did a bad job. Far from that. You did a very, very good job. Very impressed. Let me point out a few things, though, that you might think about for the future to improve your performance. We've got some notes here. I want to say a little bit about how you speak, also a bit about your presence on the stage, which means your movements and your actions, and then finally a little bit about the content of what you were saying. Now overall, I thought the pronunciation was very good. I could understand everything you said. The main problem with your speech is something called intonation. That's the main problem. Now, what that means is that sometimes some of you spoke too flat. Every word gets the same amount of emotion. Some of you spoke with too much emotion, and you're too up and too down, and too up and too down. And that's a bit unnatural. You have to think, what am I talking about? Is it something very emotional? Then you should show emotion. If it's not, you should probably limit your emotion, okay? So the intonation was something of a problem for some of the groups. The second problem is your action on the stage. When do you ever do that? I saw a lot of people, they stomp on the stage, right? Or they do this. What does that mean? What do you think? I mean, what? Right? It means that, right? But a lot of you would use this gesture.
Or you would use this gesture.
That's an unusual gesture. Why should you do that? You might do it sometimes, but I wouldn't do it a lot. The same with this. That's an unusual gesture. I would never, ever do that, I think. So why are you doing that? It may be that it means something in Taiwan, right? It has a Taiwanese meaning, but it may not mean something to a native speaker of English. So you might think, should I use that kind of gesture? Is that the right thing to do? Or should I be a little more natural? Okay, hang on, let me see.
There's one other point I wanted to make about speech.
Okay, well, I'll move on to the last part, the content. I'll say two things about content. One is the frame around your presentation. The frame means when I start watching you do your play, can I figure out what your main point is? Now, for a few groups, it took me about a minute or a minute and a half to figure out where you were going, right? I think it would be better if you can help your audience understand your goal a little bit sooner. Now, one way to do that is to give your play a title, your performance a title. Some of you use the title of the contest. That doesn't really tell me what your content will be. So I suggest choosing a title that helps the audience predict the content. Now the final thing is a bit difficult too, and this is the most critical point. A lot of times, the difference between Taiwan and Taiwanese people and foreign people was a difference between knowledge and science and people who are just workers. That difference is a stereotype, right? In Taiwan, we do have science and technology and education. So do people in other countries. Sometimes I felt like Taiwan is where the smart people are, and then people who need our help, the victims, are somewhere else. I'm not criticizing you for consciously doing that. I'm not suggesting you're doing that because you feel better than other people, but that came off sometimes. So I would try to consider looking at this partnership. A lot of you said cooperation and partnership, to see it really as equal. And that equality also means intelligence and intellect and knowledge, okay? So I'll leave you that point. So my points are quite critical, but again, I want to congratulate you all. You did a fine job. Thank you.
大家好，那我首先要恭喜大家。那第一个我要恭喜主办的单位，那我猜外交部主办单位听了应该很高兴，那高兴的点，我觉得应该我知道这个计划已经执行很多年了，那那个新南向也推行很多年了。那我觉得今天应该高兴的是说。 我们的主题很多元，很多面向。那我想是同学对这个西南向的各个面向都已经有很多的接触，因为我今天听到的是有包括商业、农业，那有旅游，那有文化，那甚至有留游学这个各个面向几乎都有包的。这是一个活动上面我觉得比较可以恭喜的地方。那第二个就是要恭喜同学。 因为我知道同学们已经练习很久了，那要 teamwork 也不容易，那要上台把整个这样组合起来也很不容易。那像我在大学当任老师，那每年我们外文系都有一个毕业公演，那所以我知道这样子是很辛苦的一个过程，所以首先呢要恭喜大家完成这样一个团体的群体的一个工作，那表现得都很好。 那接下来呢，就给大家一些些我的小小的心得了。那第一个就是，我刚刚说了嘛，大家有很多主题，西南向很多主题。那每一个你选定了一个主题之后，要胜出，我是觉得需要有一个简单、强而有力的主轴，你的表现要有重点。 那我举一些例子给你听哈。那譬如说，就是你如果是强调商业，好，我们的商贸往来，那你的 team 如果你的重点是什么？是有些 team 就是强调你是双方的哈，一个双赢的局面哈，是两个互相 country benefit 的过程，那你就有亮点哈。那甚至在这个过程里面，在论述的过程里面，你就巧妙的丢进去台湾的优势，哈，它经贸的优势是什么？你把它再巧妙的丢进去哈，这样你的这个呈现上面就有一个强而有力的重点。那如果你要呈现的是文化交流，那文化交流太 vague 很 general 哈，那会失焦。那如果你把它做一个重点，是譬如说你是 respect other， 啊，那怎么样？那强调你是尊重人家的文化，那通常会有些什么误解？这样你就有一个亮点哈。那如果你要讲的是高中生来讲，那个怎么样 promote 或了解政府男性新娘向的政策？那你可能要抓一个亮点哈，比如说，哎，有哪些平台哈，那或是有哪些资讯，甚至 how to get it 哈，那这个都会让你的表演，因为只有四分钟到五分钟哈，会有一个主轴，会有强而有力这样哈。那另外在技术方面哈，我觉得蛮多 team 都加入一些文化的元素，蛮好的哈，比如说你巧妙的丢进去。人家的食物的文化啦，哈，衣着这些，那都可以表现你对别人的文化的了解，哈，这个也是蛮不错的。那有一些创新的东西哈，比如说呈现的方式哈，可以活泼一点哈，你结合可能是一个 interview， 可能你变成 TV， 你变成 IG 哈，这些都是可以让你的表演哈比较有特殊性的地方哈。那另外最后一点啦哈，就是因为它是一个表演嘛哈，那这一点可能是同学有些要更带回去思考跟改善的地方哈。因为一个表演呢，它不是一个演讲。那有些 team 比较可惜，就是你的内容非常好，但是你会背太多台词哈，是比较吃亏的哈。那呈现比较静态，或是你们讲话的时候是对着几个人讲。并不是对着 audience 讲哈，会比较建议说把它的内容这么丰富的内容，你还是要把它组织一下，断成比较多的段落，那用比较活泼的方式，简洁的呈现，这样会比较好哈。那最后一点，我要分享一下我自己的心得哈。那我觉得一路这样长大，我们台湾的同学哈，都太容易很快的责备自己。你要记得，你要肯定自己哈。那我要讲的是那个小小的失常的状况，因为你在练习的时候，你对自己有一个 expectation 哈，那你要达到怎么样的效果？那你上来总是会有一些不在你的控制之下，或是没有像你的期待，这是正常的哈，连老师们也都会哈。那这个为什么很重要呢？你要肯定自己哈，不要急着责备自己，因为你在在这个过程里面，有些小小失常的地方，我看到的是你的 teammate 就很快的跳进来支援你哈。那这个也是一个很重要的。那你自己能不能很快的恢复，啊，能不能很快的 recover， 这些东西啊，很快的再 encourage 自己，这个在你们将来工作跟求学都是很重要的能力哈。那所以你自己要肯定自己，然后继续的。加油，这样哈，好，谢谢大家。
真的要谢谢大家，这个像我想很多同学跟我一样，其实今天我也是第一次参加小尖兵的比赛，跟大家一样也感觉很紧张，有的时候该 emotional 的时候要 emotional 一下。但是真的这一天下来，很多同学表现我们都看在眼里，非常的杰出，非常的棒。那我要说的是，这个临危受命，我拿了这份是大家最关心的事情，好不好？那我们长话短说，那我们就来 ，The Oscar goes to 第一队，序号二号。第二队，序号三号。That's what we're looking for。第三队序号五号。 恭喜。第四队序号六号。第五队序号十一号。待会再上台领奖。第六队序号十二。第七队序号十六号。现在大家是比分贝。第八队序号十七号。第九队序号十八号。第十队序号二十五号。还好我们是在室内。第十一队序号二十七号。第十二队序号二十八号。第十三队序号二十九号。第十四队序号三十号。对，再叫大声一点。第十五队序号三十一号。好了，那这样大家很清楚了。第十六队序号三十二号。好，恭喜各位！但是再次告诉大家，今天在座每一位都是赢家，我们真的感觉到每一位参赛的同学们都表现非常优异，谢谢大家。